We all walk, drive, ride through the streets of London and have passed hundreds of fried chicken shops. Do you notice them? Do you despise them? Are you a regular? Whatever your experience of what is becoming an iconic inner London setup, I want to take you a step further into these outlets, unveil what lies beyond the chicken, and uncover then why it is that fried chicken shops are saturating our streets. You vibrant and you fresh and all original to say the least that you've impressed. Come on, come on. Rapid start that they stole, finding it very hard to make it over the wall. Hey, get your weight up, my motto, you heard. And I go to death here to felonious words, huh? So girls, move it around. If you see your main dog, give your brother a pound and just, breathe and stop, for real. And give it what you got and just, breathe and stop, for real. And give it what you got, and give it what you got, and give it what you got. And if you're on the block, and give it what you got, give it, A thug a grill, you would mean it's an eye. I wanna feel you, the big thighs. Your Prada dress or your Gucci bag, whether polo jeans or a doobie bag, You hold the door, aight? We coming through, try deep, hold it down for the night. Big Moo got the D, like he got the E, and girl, you got the gift, Turn it over the page, usher in all of y'all to a brand new age where status really don't matter. Everybody get right to the pitter. Growing up in London, this global city, I feel like there are fewer and fewer spaces that can be shared by everyone, that are inclusive, non-selective, and importantly, allow young people to feel a sense of both belonging and agency. Spaces where we feel we have a sense of control, choice, independence. Fried chicken shops are filling this void.
I think it's quite excellent because all the younger children go to them after school.
Like, it's a smart idea because a lot of different people come here and lots of people are going to look at the advert and be like, you know what, now I want a night thing as well.
I thought in a chicken shop it's cool because you never see adverts like that in a chicken shop. And I also feel like having it in a chicken shop probably picks up more the type of people who would buy the shoes than if you had it on a bus stop. Because also, if I see an advert on a bus stop, I'm a bit like, it's a bit lame. Like, are you McDonald's?
So the reason I came to Morley's is obviously, it's the Pengus Munch in the end. So I walked into Morley's, I saw the advert for Lucozade, and obviously, it goes with the munch. It's the, yeah, the original flavour is the best.
Because the target market, like, you get a lot of the younger kids in here, and they're coming in here for their chicken, and 150%, yeah, 100%, you'd get the business from here.
So. Morley's, so yeah, like seeing my local shop, working with like one of my favourite TV shows is like pretty much the most amazing thing you could ever think of, being in London.
Man, in every area, you can go to many, many, many ends around the UK. You're gonna find a chicken shop.
So their relevance is being recognised and an image of London is being showcased to the world that's got nothing to do with Buckingham Palace or Burberry. It's an image that for once, ordinary people can take some ownership of.
They asked about the Bible I was reading. Told them that the title was misleading. Labelled it Jerusalem, but really it's for cooking Middle East. And I could see that mine was changing with the seasons. Shaded for a reason. They would start decreasing. Leaving like the orange in the evening. It was creeping through the clouds, but now I'm proud to see the images releasing. I just wish the little lady could have seen them. But she was